Is it illegal to shoot a wizard? Okay, so tonight I'm going to shoot the Wizard Nebula. It's in the kind of northern sky. It's the biggest patch of sky I have at my house, other than the fact that Cafe Rio is right there. But now I have my cool CLS filter. That should mitigate some of the issues. The Wizard Nebula is an open cluster of stars in the constellation of Cepheus. And the surrounding emission nebulosity is called the Wizard Nebula. So it was discovered by William Herschel's sister Caroline. Way to be Caroline. It's 20 light years across and about 7,200 light years away, with a magnitude of 7.2, and its designation is NGC 7380. And now back to our regularly scheduled programming. Wizard Nebula. I guess it kind of looks like a wizard with outstretched hands and a pointy hat if you're on drugs and squint really hard, I guess. I don't know. Anyway, so I should be able to shoot all the way from when it gets dark to 3 or 4 o'clock in the morning. So I'm just going to spend one night on it, shoot 3 minute exposures, hopefully with my mount pointing towards the north a little more and not straight up in the air, I can get a little bit better guiding. I'm still gonna balance a little east heavy and front heavy. That seems to help. We'll see. Okay, let's set it a wizard. Here's the result.fit file from Cyril and Stack. Background extraction, photometric color calibration, as usual. So let's start with some new layer from visible and do a little stretching. Curves.
Okay, I'm gonna start to see a little nebula. One more level. Oh, one more for good measure. Okay, flatten that. And export this as RGB underscore test 5. Okay, we'll copy that into the StarNet directory terminal. Change directory to StarNet folder. And we will run StarNet. Okay, StarNet plus is now done. Terminal. Let's open the starless image. That looks okay. All right, so copy that. New layer, paste. Anchor layer, and do a subtract. Okay, so there's my stars only image, flatten that. So I have a lot of red stars also. I think that has to do with my filter, I'm not sure, but I'm going to do some star reduction. I'm going to do on the white stars and the red stars. So zoom in a little bit. Do a select by color. Grow, feather, okay, filter distorts, value propagate. More black. Okay, that worked a little. Now we'll do it to the white. Same thing, select by color. Choose white this time. Grow by 3. Feather by 5. Value propagate. More black. Okay, I'm okay with that. So now we'll go back to the nebula. New layer from visible. We can do much with levels, a little bit. Too much. One more. All right, just a little bit of saturation. I can't help myself. I have to overprocess. I'm going to sharpen just a little bit too. All right. Kill just a little black, not from there. I'll have to do it from curves. And my fans on my computer are just taking off. All right. Flatten that. Copy. Back to here. New layer. Paste. Okay. Anchor layer. Addition. All right. Flatten that. Transform, rotate 180 degrees. Now it looks a little more wizardy. Okay, we'll crop just a little. So we can make the nebula a little more prominent. And there we go. Well, as always, please give me a like, maybe subscribe. I'll talk to you later, and clouds suck.